Hi, everybody. Welcome to another Prog Report podcast interview. My guest today is the lead singer, bassist, and main songwriter for one of the great prog bands around. Of course, I'm talking about Riverside, who have a brand new album, their seventh studio album called Wasteland, which comes out September 28th. I'd like to welcome Marius Duda.
Hello, Roy. This is Marius.
How you doing, man? Good to talk to you again. It's been a while.
It's been a while, exactly.
Well, look, man, thanks for giving me some time. I know you're busy and everything's sort
of... Everyone's busy.
It's ramping up now, right? So the album's done a while back and now it's going out to press. What are you doing now to get ready for the release? What's your day like now?
Now I'm just doing interviews and fixing some stuff before my holiday because I'm going to take a short break next week.
Yeah.
For the first time since, I don't know, 5 years. So, yeah.
That's good. That's good, man. You guys just played Night of the Prog. I mean, I wasn't there, unfortunately. I heard that was a great show. I think you played maybe a little bit from the new album. A song, was it? I mean, you know, how was that show? How was playing some new material if you did? What was that like?
I really liked that. I really loved that. We played lots of kind of interesting stuff because for the first time since, I don't remember, 10 years, we played Reality Dream Part 1. We also played Left Out because people during Night of the Prog really like to sing this song. And we played something from the new album and we played a special version of The Day After.
All right, so now Riverside is back, a new album. I know... You know, you guys went through a lot with Pieter passing and everything that you went through, a lot of stuff yourself a couple of years ago, last time we spoke, and the band was close to maybe not, you know, shutting down. How does it feel to have a new album and to be coming back again with it? What kind of place are you in right now with all of this?
Well, it feels great, you know, for me. I'm so happy that we did this album because... after all the tragic events that we've got, we finally have to move on and do something, right? Yeah. I'm a bit tired of this, you know, situation when we put the picture of three of us and people that they're just doing this emoji with the tear, right?
Yeah.
And I'm just asking the question, what the fuck, you know? enough of this, you know? I know that for some people it's hard to deal with the fact that there is no Piotr, but... they need to remember that we have to deal with that, you know, even more. But we still want to do something and move on. So Wasteland it's not a chapter about what happened before. It's a new chapter. You know, it's about surviving in a different land. And I think that because of this title and because of the theme of the new album, there is lots of symbolic and I don't have to say about, you know, the lyrics because too literal, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
It's you can read between the lines lots of things, you know, that this is because of the situation in the band, that this is because of the situation in the world. So it's really multidimensional, and I'm really glad that we did that kind of album, you know, right now.
It's a real... deep album. It feels like it has a lot of, I don't know what the right word is, but like weight to it. It's when you listen to it, you feel like that was really something, you know. I don't know how to explain it.
I know your point. It was really hard to be honest. I thought that when I've been listening to that after some break, because I took a break after the final mix, and then when I listened to that after, I don't know, 2 weeks of break, I just realized that, wow, it's really deep.
Yeah.
But we couldn't do that earlier. It, you know, something had to happen to do that kind of album. Yeah. Plus, maybe I had to turn 40 or grew up. But it's different layer of emotions. I think I always wanted to reach that point, but you know, I didn't want to have all these things that happened. But unfortunately, maybe because of the final result, some kind of things like that, like happened, maybe they should happen. I don't know. I can't find the words, right words for that. But that's very true. This is a totally different album, and not only because Piotr is not with us anymore, and not because of the sound, but the emotions are totally different right now.
Yeah, I mean, there's. I want to get into some of the songs, and of course, a lot of people will not have heard them by the time we put this out. But you know, for example, a song like "Guardian Angel" is like nothing I've heard you guys do before, and I wasn't sure that was even you singing. You know, at first when I heard it. So, talk about that song to give people an idea. It's a mostly just piano song. You're singing with a real kind of deep voice, and it's very like a very emotional song, I think. But talk about the decision to approach it that way.
Well, when we started to work on it, when I started to compose the new songs, I really wanted to start a new chapter. This is a different band right now, and I think the worst thing that we could do, it would be if we, I don't know, take the guy who looks exactly like Piotr and do exactly that kind of songs to prove that nothing's happened, right? That we can still move on, you know, with that kind of style and everything. No. I asked myself a question, what is important for me in the music? Because I did lots of stuff with Lunatic Soul recently. You know, I was in the studio all the time, and The Wasteland is like the third album in a row, or even fourth when I take also Eye of the Soundscape. Yeah. So it was like the fourth album in a row in the studio, and I was really I really wanted to try something else. And I think first thing that I decided to do is just like the skip of this Brit rock influences this time. Mm-hmm. So I know it's hard, right? If we have this Pink Floyd influences all the time, but okay, but that's it, enough. Let's try something else. And I wanted to focus on some different things, like, for instance, Slavian melodies this time. You know, more like, it's kind of joke, but more like this patriotic Polish songs in some way. the different of emotions, it's more like the hymn than the normal melancholic song, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, I hear that, yeah.
So I just wanted to focus. Plus, I really wanted to do that in a more manly way. And I remember that when I took some vocal lessons before the Towards the Blue Horizon tour for the first time after 14. Mm-hmm. Good for me. my teacher said to me, why don't you use the lower parts? Why do you always use, you know, the higher voice? And I said to him that I always had to be above the instruments during my sound check and everything, and he said, no, just please, you've got a very good voice and you need to believe that you should use that. And I realized that I always use that kind of voice as a backing vocal but never as a main one. So I thought, okay, maybe for this album it may be also one of these points, you know, with the different what to do different now. And and lower singing was one of these things.
Well, it's interesting because the way it's placed in the album too is it's a good transition in the record, I think, right? Because the beginning is a bit maybe more reliable Riverside sounding. Acid Rain and Veil of Tears has the metal guitar and okay, you sort of, okay, this is Riverside. Right. And then all of a sudden, okay, here we go. It's not all going to be the Acid Rain or Veil of Tears. We're throwing some other stuff at you. And then from there on, the album really starts to go all over the place and different kind of new styles that you guys introduce, which I think is it's really, really interesting stuff, some of the songwriting and directions you take.
You know, I'm really tired of these the same prog influences that I always hear in every band, you know. I really wanted to finally skip because, okay, I say in the interviews that I want to get rid of this Porcupine Tree influences or Dream Theater influences and that kind of stuff. Yeah. But unfortunately, always there was something in Riverside's music. Until now, I think. If someone will tell me that he listened to Stephen Wilson on The Wasteland, so I would say to myself, okay, I think you're just simply deaf. it's nothing in common with Dream Theater this time.
Not even close. No, so, I agree.
Because maybe I just decided also to skip all these influences and create more alternative album with different styles than that. You know, yeah. And it's so funny because I can say okay, I could say something like, before I tried to do that, but never with that kind of result. So I'm really happy that Riverside, maybe for the first time, seriously, have found something which is really original in our own sound, right?
Well, and to that point is also a lot of there's a few instrumental songs or songs that only have a little bit of lyrics and kind of longer songs, a lot of playing, instrumentality. When did you choose, okay, I feel like this song is good without vocals or it needs vocals. How do you make that decision?
I wanted to create more space this time. I know that vocal, usually when it's in a lot of places, it's overwhelming sometimes. And I wanted to create the mood during the listening that you can find on the main cover of the album. So the space. And I thought, wow, maybe it's time for instrumental song on the main album finally too, right? Because the last time I think it was like Reality Dream Part 3, because the others were on the bonus CDs and were on the compilations like Eye of the Soundscape, but never on the main album.
Well, it creates a
So
little bit of a it creates a little bit of a almost like a soundtrack. If you listen to the album from beginning to end, you know, you got the rocker openings and then all of a sudden you're taken on this journey with all these different music around. It's very interesting the way it's done.
I wanted to create something which is like a soundtrack to a road movie. And of course I was inspired by The Road by Cormac McCarthy too. But you know, I saw this a bit like the post-apocalyptic Western or something like that. That's why we've got these Ennio Morricone influences too, right? In the title track.
What about I mean, the song that I just blew my mind and I love a lot is that Acid Rain song. To talk about that song because I think that's just one of the best songs I've heard this year.
I wanted to do like, Alfred Hitchcock Earthquake, at the very beginning of the album. So
Well, the
at that
second
moment.
half of it is such a cool transition that it almost shifts from a rock song to something that could have been on Eye of the Soundscape, right? It's sort of a combination song, I feel like.
It's a memory pattern, if I can say that. I did this this part like the lyrics at the very beginning, they force you into the thinking that, okay, this is the part of the memory, something that happened before the end of the world, right? These dancing ghosts, singing ghosts. I just wanted to do a good introduction, and as always, when you listen to the album, good albums always have a very nice introduction and very nice closure, right? So I think that the day after and the night before, at the title track, I mean the titles of these songs are also referring to the second life syndrome, right? After, before, because this is our second life syndrome. But the main introduction is Acid Rain. So after all these ballads, after all these mellow, albums like Love You, The Time Machine, Eye of the Soundscape, I really wanted to do some kind of, metal riff at the very beginning, just like the beginning of the song. And I wanted to say something about that. For many people, Wasteland is our own land with all these, bad flaws pouring down from the sky, or pouring down from the mouth of other
That
like scree and this yeah, all these things that I'm trying to mention in the lyrics at the very beginning. And later, I just wanted to do some kind of transition for maybe, I don't know, a nice singing during the show.
Right. That could be a good, yeah, you're right. That could be a good fan singing moment. I love that part a lot. Is there any part of this that's a little bit of a continuation of the Love, Fear, and Time Machine album with some of the because that on that album I felt like you introduced a lot of acoustic guitars and more organic recording. Is there any part of this album that continues from that?
I'm not sure. I'm dividing a bit Riverside for the old sound and the new sound. And for me, the old sound is just like from Out of Myself until Anno Domini High Definition. We were kind of more proggy on the last decade, And at the same time, more, if I can say, underground a bit with the sound and everything, you know. But with Shrine of New Generation Slaves, we focused more on the melodies. We focused more on the songs. But this time, I just wanted to bring a bit of these underground sounds from the last decade into that. That's why maybe it's a bit resembles, I don't know, Second Life Syndrome, for instance.
So I guess you're also going to start soon rehearsing for the tour. You got a big tour coming up, I think kicks off in October. And then you're also coming to the States. You're doing Cruise to the Edge again, finally. Or maybe this is your first time being on Cruise to the Edge. You did the other, the Prognation cruise, right?
Yes, we've never had a chance to be on Cruise to the Edge. So that will be our first experience.
Nice. Good to have you back on it.
Are you going to show up?
Actually, the last time I was invited to be one of the co-hosts along with John Kirkman and do some work on the ship. So I believe they've been inviting me back to do it again. So we'll see. Hopefully that will happen. What's the tour going to be like? Is it going to be focus heavily on the new album, or still a mix of everything?
We will definitely focus on the new album, and we will also show something that Riverside is a different band now. Of course, we will play. We will have Maciej on board again, Maciej Meller, which is not an official member of the band, just in general. But he's our friend from the live Riverside version. And he's just like the part of us, but of course he didn't compose the new songs. I was only by three of us. But I just want to start to play on the different instruments. So probably the piccolo bass that I played on this album will be a really important instrument right now. And lots of people will be, surprised that I'm playing on the bass, which sounds like the guitar. And there will be lots of surprises for sure. And I would like to focus also on the old stuff, but my goal is to do more dynamic shows with Riverside, and it's change something, do some middles, So I'm pretty sure that it will be quite cool stuff. And we have a chance, and we have plans to come back for an American tour, in
awesome.
May.
Oh, great!
Around Rossfest, because we're playing Rossfest next year. So we would see. The Cruise to the Edge would be only more vacation.
Right.
But the normal tour, I think it will be in May.
Great. Oh, we need a U.S. tour. That's been it's been a while, right? It's been a long time that's great. Just quickly about Lunatic Soul, because the two albums that you put out the last year and a half or so. Again, we're really big successes, got a lot of praise from all the websites and everything. Is that something that, now that with Riverside coming back, you're going to take some break from Lunatic Soul, or is that a project that now is still going to happen for you?
I'm not sure what would be the next step for me. Probably I would like to take some rest from this pattern Riverside/Lunatic Soul/Riverside/Lunatic Soul.
Yeah, you need a break.
I broke this even because I did Lunatic Soul twice.
Yeah.
But I still have two albums to complete my the Circle of Life and Death. This is how I named that. And the Circle of Life and Death has eight albums, and so far I've got six. Four main albums and two additionals. So two more albums left, but I don't know when I'm going to do that. For now, I think that maybe I will focus on Riverside again, or maybe I'll do something under my own name. So, but Lunatic Soul still will be, of course, in progress in the future.
Awesome. Well, Marius, thank you, man. I'm glad to hear, the band is back and you sound like you're doing really great and the album just kicks ass. I think people are going to love it. It's really good to have the band back. We're happy. And I think everybody's going to be thrilled.
Thank you so much, Roy. Thank you for your time.
All right, man. Thank you. Talk soon.
Thank you. That was a pleasure. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thanks to Marius for the interview. We're going to close with a track off the new album Wasteland, which comes out September 28th. This is Veil of Tears. For upcoming news and interviews, please check theprogreport.com, follow us on Facebook at The Prog Report on Twitter, or download the podcast on iTunes, Google Play, and YouTube. Thanks.
help then take away. Like you did the last time, like the last time, like the last time. Tell me who I have to be. Cross my head, lips and heart. Make me get down on my knees. Like you did the last time, like the last time, like the last time. Desert, I am wading through the desert to the promised land you burned to the ground. Wading through the desert, I am wading through the desert to the promised land you burned to the ground. Take me to the highest hill, show the fireworks display. Tell me it's for my own good. Like you did the last time, like the last time, like the last time. Turn poetry to prose, then a round trip crusade. Make another vein of tears. Like you did the last time, like the last time, like the last time. Wading through the desert, I am wading through the desert to the promised land you burned to the ground. Wading through the desert, I am wading through the desert to the promised land you burned to the ground. I am wading through the desert to the promised land.